Well, this is Marina Del Rey, and there's lots of memories attached to this song. I got the idea for the song on the way to the hotel from the airport the first time I went to L.A. And on the highway, it said, next exit, Marina Del Rey, and the car passed it, and I thought, oh, what a beautiful name that is. And so on, we went to the hotel, and it was the Universal Sheraton Hotel in Universal City, and I'd seen that hotel on the Johnny Carson show, so I knew it had a beautiful swimming pool, so I thought, I'll go for a swim. When I got to my room, I looked out, there it was, and so I put my bathing suit on, I went down to the pool, and the first person I saw leaving the water in the pool was Telly Savalas. And he was wearing a canary yellow Speedo, which looked a bit odd to me. And so I thought, I love Telly, but I won't swim today. I'll swim tomorrow and let the water go through the filtration system. So I went back to my room, and I remembered that road sign. I remembered the road sign, and it said Marina Del Rey, and I picked up my guitar and I wrote that song, and it's the fastest song I've ever written, and I love it to this day, really. It was a hit in all kinds of different really weird places, but it also, a lot of people thought it was Jimmy Buffett, and I think that's because the marimba player on Marina Del Rey was Jimmy Buffett's marimba player. So I think people associate that sound with Jimmy Buffett. But to me, it just sounds like summertime. And who else played on that record? The great and powerful Jeff Porcaro, who's sadly died years ago, but he was one of the great drummers. He was the drummer in Toto, and basically the people that played on that record were later became Toto. So there was Steve Lukather, David Paich played piano, and turned out to be a great record. So I had a lot of fun doing that. Oh, that's the record I met Donald Fagen, because I was signed by Steely Dan's producer, Gary Katz. So he got Donald Fagen to come in and play. Donald used to play, he played piano, but he played an Arp Odyssey, and a lot of old keyboard players will know what that synthesizer is. But it was very, very compact and complex synthesizer. And Donald came in, and he was a lovely guy. And I was, of course, awestruck, because I'm such a Steely Dan fan. And he played on it, too, and he was very, very nice. That song was great, from a great experience from beginning to end, and it was the only song that I wrote in California, and I guess it sounds like it.
Thanks for watching Behind the Vinyl. We have got a ton more episodes available to you. Your favorite artists with your favorite stories. And here's the thing, we're updating Behind the Vinyl all the time. So if you want to stay up to date on that, simply subscribe by clicking right up here. And you can do us a huge favor by sharing some Behind the Vinyls on your socials. Thanks.